And... I mean, you don't do that. Come on, dude. What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we are here with a very, very special BMW M3 E92. This is a freaking cool car. This might be the coolest E92 M3 I've ever seen or driven. It is a really cool project by a guy named Dennis, and he has taken a standard black E92 M3 and turned it into this beast of a car, this G-Power supercharged E92 M3. So today I'm going to show you around it, show you all the cool stuff on this car, and then we'll take it for a drive towards the Autobahn for an Autobahn blast. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to receive updates when we upload a new video, or check us out on Instagram if you like for some behind the scenes footage. So let me paint you a picture and introduce you to Dennis, who is a real BMW guy. As a daily, he has a BMW M5 E39 with a manual gearbox. That is an awesome car. Before this, he drove an M3 F80, which is also a great car. And then he bought this. He was able to buy this car at a great price. I mean, these E92s, they're not that expensive anymore. And, you know, you've got that naturally aspirated 4-liter V8 engine with 420 horsepower. So you would think, great, great car. But if you come from an F80, an E92 is going to feel slow, because the mid-range power of an F80 is just so much stronger than this. Yeah, it is a world of difference. So this will feel slow if you're used to an F80. So he decided to upgrade it, and he decided to do that at G-Power. So they started talking and came up with a 510 horsepower tuning package, which is very, very nice for a car like this that weighs 1600 kilos. But then things started rolling, and he ended up with this supercharger kit delivering 650 horsepower and around 590 newton meters of torque. So that's the introduction done. I'm going to walk around it, show you a couple of cool things on this car. First, let's start with the carbon fiber hood, which is absolutely gorgeous, with that massive power bulge here, those vents, and well, the color is, it's, as I said, he bought a black M3 and he had it painted in San Marino blue. How cool is that? So this is not, you know, BMW never officially had this on the E92, but this is a BMW color. So I think it looks absolutely beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. A cool thing is that this, I noticed this immediately, that there's a big panel gap here. As you can see, it seems like the hood is not closed properly, but that is because the intercooler there is too thick, so it doesn't fit. So they have to move the bumper forwards a couple of centimeters to make room for the intercooler. You can actually see that it's super tight in there, and that's why it looks like this. But I think it actually looks pretty cool from the front, because I mean, it looks a bit weird, but if you know that it's there for a purpose, I think it's very cool. Now, moving on to the wheels. These are Vorsteiner wheels, very nice forged wheels, 19-inch wrapped in Michelin Pilot Supersport rubber. And he also upgraded the brakes to Brembo Gran Turismo, because he said, if you have 650 horsepower, the standard brakes suddenly feel really bad. Well, they are bad as standard as well. So I know why you upgraded them. This is a great setup. I just can't get over this beautiful blue. There is one thing though, we're not going to hold this against Dennis because he didn't spec this car, but the first owner of this car spec'd this car with a sunroof, and that means that you cancel the carbon fiber roof, and I think that is just, that's just a cardinal sin. I mean, you don't do that. Come on, dude. What are you thinking? Carbon fiber roof is so awesome, and then you have this stupid steel roof. I mean, can you imagine how cool this would have looked with the carbon there, the carbon here, and the carbon there? But I mean, yeah, this is cool too, but that would have been even cooler, because look at that. This entire trunk lid, boot lid, whatever, is made from carbon fiber. I'll open it for you guys so you can see. Look at that. That is beautiful. This is also from G-Power. So is the hood and so is the rear wing. But this is a really cool feature. This little ducktail here with that wing. And then Dennis decided to have it painted up until this line here, which I think is just super awesome. I think, again, it has to be the coolest M3 I've ever seen. We've also got an Akrapovic exhaust front to rear with race cats, so 200 cell race cats in there as well. And it also has Öhlins suspension. So, Öhlins dampers, I think, actually. So, it's a serious setup. And look at that. The orange from G-Power always shines through. That is something I really do like about G-Power, that they keep that orange theme all around the car, and that you can actually see some of those details through the car. I mean, if this is closed and you look at it, you know, you have that little plaque there, or if you look at it from this side, you can see the orange in there as well. The brake calipers are painted to match that as well, which is awesome. But this is a G-Power compressor kit, as you can see, supercharger that takes it from 420 horsepower and 400 newton meters to 650 horsepower and 590 newton meters of torque. So a very, very nice performance increase, and it just looks freaking awesome. There are a few problems with the software. Yeah, that's closed properly. So the software, yeah, we're going to feel that when we drive it, but I'll talk you through that in a minute. And on the entire interior has been done as well, which is just so cool. This awesome cage in the rear, again, painted in that orange, the rear seat delete with the Alcantara and the G-Power leather or Alcantara stitched on there as well. Whoa. What a cool car. Oh man, I am absolutely in love with this freaking thing. So we've got these amazing G-Power seats as well, Recaros. And they are, I mean, they're racing seats, so they are super snug. And when we get in it, you actually notice that you're not straight in front of the steering wheel. You're a bit to the left. So I don't know if that's because of these seats, but this is very strange. But it is, I mean, it's not too bad. We've got this beautiful carbon fiber steering wheel with that Alcantara orange again. Orange on the pedal shifters, Alcantara on the dash. Everything was taken out and covered in Alcantara. The center console as well. G-Power V8 565 8B40 compressor. Or is that an S? S65. Oh, S65 for the engine. B40 compressor, serial number 0939, first class performance. Alcantara on the center console, absolutely gorgeous. Such a cool, I mean, it looks like a freaking race car in here. And it feels like that as well. We even have these matching gloves with black and orange. Nice touch, Dennis. Very nice touch. Okay, so we are going to use the harness. He also has regular seat belts, but the harness starts jiggling around in the rear, and we don't want that during the video. So we're going to wear it, but you don't have to every day. So that's a good thing. All right, so. Oh, very, very snug. Oh, I should have taken out the key first. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so we'll start it up. And we've got this little display here as well. We've got an oil temperature gauge, which we are going to keep a close eye on. And well, the interior, I mean, I have to say, the Alcantara in here actually makes it feel so much fresher than it actually is, because it's, I mean, it's from 2008. So it's quite an old car basically, but the Alcantara really makes it feel fresh. It's a good upgrade. We also have the G-Power Speedo that goes all the way up to 400 kilometers an hour. Man, this is awesome. Okay, we're going to go for M mode, and we're going to go for DSC off, because the DSC is way too intrusive if you ask me. And then we're going to go for the most ferocious setting for the 7-speed DCT gearbox. Here we go, let's take it for a little drive and I'll try to talk a bit about how this car feels. All right, so let's start by driving it towards this little overpass. Oh, this sound is ridiculous. It sounds like nothing else I've ever driven. It is a very strange experience. Okay, so second gear. It sounds very, very racy. And even though we have a full Krapovich exhaust with race cats, it's not that loud. It's more, yes, you do hear the V8, but it doesn't scream as much as I was expecting. But there is one thing, and I'm pretty sure that that is... And I'm pretty sure that that is the supercharger. This Darth Vader breathing sound when you release the throttle is absolutely insane. Oh, it sounds so good. Oh, it sounds like an angry race car. And we've got those Öhlins dampers. We've got a setup done by, oh, I forgot the name, Mendola Racing, something like that. They have set up the suspension, which is really, really good. You can feel that it's much stiffer, lower, harder than stock, but still, it soaks up most of the bumps fine. So that suspension setup is a really good addition too, because Dennis told us that this happened over the course of 2.5 years. Like, he started upgrading things and it just got completely out of hand, basically, but in a very good way. But every time you do something, you notice that something else could be improved. You know what I mean? And that led to this crazy machine. I mean, that those DCT shifts, I don't know if the gearbox software has been changed as well. I can imagine it is, but I'm not sure. But those shifts are so quick. Oh, but it will absolutely light up those rear tires. But the great thing about the supercharger is that the power is quite linear, so it doesn't surprise you like a heavily turbocharged engine would do. Like, if this was a 650 horsepower turbocharged M3, it would be way trickier to drive. This actually feels really quite natural, like BMW did this, almost. Oh, but it is so freaking quick. Oh my god. And those shifts, those upshifts are crazy fast. Now, as I said, there are a few problems with the software that Dennis is still working on. So if you downshift, you have like, okay, let me demonstrate that again. Downshift, throttle, nothing happening. And then suddenly it goes and then it has like a mood, this car. So sometimes it will behave a little bit difficult in its power delivery, but as long as you're absolutely flooring it, it is insane. Oh. Oh my god, and it is so quick. Jeez. Oh, that's a Corvette. We're going to play with him, I think, if we can catch up. Here we go, full throttle. That is freaking quick. Holy moly. Okay, so we had to turn around because the road was closed ahead and the Corvette didn't want to play anyway. So we're going to see if we can do anything fun on the other side. But I have to say, the steering feel, it's really, really good actually. The car feels so tied down, where a stock M3 can feel quite loose if you're used to more modern cars. Oh, but it is very, very quick. Accelerate. Oh, it just keeps going, like it doesn't really dip, you know, it feels like it will keep going if I don't shift. Yeah, there we go. Has to think for a second what it needs to do. That's already 300 on the speedo, but I know that that's nowhere near 300 GPS speed. Oh man, the brakes do shake a little bit, but performance is really good. Oh, there we go. That's very strange. After a downshift, it just needs to think about what it wants to do. So of course we also measured the 100 to 200 performance, and we actually measured it at 6.15 is the fastest time. That's around the same time as a Porsche 992 Turbo S or an Aston Martin DBS Superleggera, which is really crazy. Okay, so I'm just going to end it here, guys. I absolutely love this car. This car is in my top 10 cars I've ever driven. It is magnificent. So really good job, Dennis. Awesome job. To you guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. You can subscribe by clicking the big button in the middle. You can also check out this video or go check out this playlist. See you at the next one. Bye.